Hi guys, my name is Manira Wrights and I'm a writer, journalist and now YouTube blogger. And I decided to make a YouTube video so you guys can know a little bit more about me and find out why I'm on YouTube. So getting right into it, the first fact about me is that I'm of Somali origin. Both my parents emigrated from Somalia when I was just 2 years old. So fact number two about me is that I can speak three languages, Somali, English and Dutch. Fact number three about me is that I'm really passionate about women's rights and women empowerment and inspiring young girls to love themselves and to love their bodies. You know, that's why I did a workshop in my local town of Coventry where I encourage young girls to love themselves, to love their bodies. And what I really want to do is go out there and do workshops in all communities. You know, one day I want to come to your community, your city, your town, and speak to you and really get to know you a lot better and encourage you to love yourselves and to love your body. For me, it's all about encouraging young girls, you know, to love themselves, to love their bodies, you know, through doing workshops. I hope to do that one day. And, you know, that's something I'm really, really passionate about. Fact number four about me is that I graduated with a degree in journalism from university quite a few years back now. But when I went on to, I just want to share, like, when I went on to do my degree in journalism, it wasn't like an easy process. You know, I graduated with only two GCSEs. I'm not encouraging anyone out there to go out and only aim for two GCSEs, but I'm just wanted to let you know that if you did get your results this year, or if you have not got the grades that you wanted to get and you want to get somewhere, or you want to go to university, or you want to do anything, you shouldn't let those grades affect you. You know, I can remember teachers telling me that I would never go to university, and that somebody with my grades just wasn't academically going to survive in university. But I didn't let that, you know, discourage me. I studied really, really hard. I went back to college and I did a few years in college and I went on to university and I got my 2.1, and I'm really, really glad and happy about that. And I'm not saying that to boast or to say, you know, look what the grade that I got, because I'm sure there's other people out there that get better grades than me. But I just want to let you know that if you've got a dream or an ambition, don't let anybody else hold you back from that. You know, don't let anybody else tell you that you can't achieve it or that you can't, you know, make it happen, because you can. You have the ability to do that. You know, with me, it was the support of my friends and my family members who kind of supported me. You know, my mom, she really encouraged me to get educated, and I pushed through, and alhamdulillah, you know, I went on to, you know, get my degree in the end. So it doesn't matter, you know, how long the journey is. All that matters is that you reach the finish line. It doesn't matter how many years, how many days, how many months you continue to work on your dream and your ambition. As long as you're working towards something that you love, that's all that really matters, to be honest. Fact number five about me is that I am absolutely petrified of spiders. I can't stand spiders or any animal that crawls or moves. I don't like rats. I don't like mouses. I don't like hamsters. Any animal that moves, I don't like. It just scares me, you know. I can't stand any. I know that sounds really, really cruel. I mean, I love animals, but it's just, I can't stand it. That and heights. I'm petrified of heights. Every time I go on a plane, you know, when I'm going to workshops or I'm visiting friends and I'm on a plane, I'm absolutely petrified. Like, I'm that person that's sitting like this, like, when are we going to land? I can't stand it, you know. Animals that crawl and heights and me just don't go. Fact number six about me is that I run a blog called Manira Writes. I've been running it for the last, you know, 3 to 4 years. Ever since I graduated, I've been running it online. And on my blog, I write about issues that's affecting young girls and young women, whether it's relationship issues, whether it's feminism issues, whether it's issues about, you know, poverty. I talk about a lot of different things through my blog, and that's how I connect with a lot of my readers. And, you know, that's a platform that, my blog is a platform that I use to reach out to young girls and young women. And, you know, It allows me to inspire and encourage young women, and it's allowed me to meet a lot of young women as well. You know, when I go to other workshops and other events that other young women are holding, it's great that they can connect with my blog. You know, that's something I'm really proud of, because it took me a long time to find that courage to run it. You know, sometimes you want to do something and then you yourself stop yourself. And I found that a lot of the times, you know, it's ourselves that stop ourselves from achieving the goals that we want to do. You know, sometimes you might have a goal that you want to gain, whether it's to do with your weight, whether it's to do with your skin, whether it's to do, you know, with your career. It could be about anything. Sometimes we stop ourselves and we make ourselves believe that, you know, we're incapable of doing, you know, certain things, and that's not always the case. You know, we just need to have faith in ourselves and believe in ourselves. And that's what I've learned over the last couple of years. I've learned to, you know, be proud of my achievements. Sometimes, you know, I've seen within our society, like when somebody does something really successful, they're really, you know, humble about it. And I think they should be. They should definitely be humble about it. But be proud of your achievement, you know. If you've achieved a really good grade at school or college or university, be proud about it. Go out and celebrate it. Celebrate yourself. There's nothing wrong with celebrating who you are, loving who you are, and celebrating that. You know, that's something that I really do encourage young girls to do. I think we don't do that enough. I think with men, as soon as they do achieve something great, you know, all the boys come together and they encourage each other. And I think that same sisterhood needs to be developed within, you know, young girls and young women. We need to encourage ourselves. That's why whenever I see somebody doing great on, you know, Instagram or Twitter, I'm always rooting for them, always supporting them, retweeting them, because I love seeing young girls and young women do well. Fact number seven about me is that I don't have my license. Again, this is not something I'm proud of, but it's definitely something I'm working on. You know, for me, when I'm behind the wheel, again, I'm like this, you know, just so literally scared. Like, I've got the steering like this, and I'm just like, I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die. And I know I need to get over that fear. You know, I think we all have different things that maybe we're scared of. And for me, driving is definitely that one thing that petrifies me. You know, I'd love to know what petrifies you. What, you know, if there's anything out there that scares you. For me, when I'm driving and I'm taking my lessons, you know, I've been taking my lessons for a year now, and it's really difficult sometimes because, you know, I see other people driving, people younger than me, people older than me, and they all in their cars and they're driving away, and it's so easy for them. But it's something that I struggle with whenever I'm driving. Like, I'm always petrified that I'm gonna go in an accident, or somebody's gonna die, or, you know, all these thoughts go in my head, thoughts that are just absolutely rubbish and not real at all. But I'm learning to overcome this, and I think the more lessons I take, for me, I'm just saying to myself right now that it doesn't matter how long it takes me to get it, as long as I get it at the end. And I hope you too, you know, if you have something that scares you that you're working through, just keep working through it, you know, one day at a time. It doesn't matter how long it takes, it doesn't matter how slow your progress is. You know, any progress is better than no progress. Slow progress is better than no progress. So just keep at it, you know, and I'll let you know how my driving is going. And if finally one day maybe I'll get my license, and I'll share that with you guys. But for now, you know, this is definitely something I'm working on. So, fact number eight about me is that I absolutely love traveling. So far, I have been this year, I've been to Egypt, I've been to America, I've been to Holland. I loved being at all of those different places, seeing the different cultures. You know, when I went scuba diving in Egypt, that was absolutely amazing. You know, it was just one of the most incredible experiences that I've ever had, and I would definitely encourage you to go out there and travel. You know, it's all great being ambitious, being driven, being, you know, going and chasing that money and, you know, chasing that wealth. There's absolutely nothing wrong with that, but you should enjoy life as well. Go out there, travel, meet people like yourself that are into the same things that you are. You know, for me, I went with my friends and a few family members, and it was absolutely amazing. You know, because I'm Dutch myself, going back to Holland was absolutely amazing. The food there is incredible, as usual. You know, I went and I had some falafel, some Dutch oorlog. You know, all these things I'm saying are Dutch foods that are absolutely amazing. So if you ever go to Holland, be sure to visit Amsterdam, Rotterdam, Den Haag, all the capitals, and go out there and meet people that live in villages, that live in small communities. You know, that's the best thing about traveling, is meeting new people. So fact number 9 about me is that I come from a very big family. I have 4 brothers and 3 sisters. So growing up, my house was always packed. We always had a lot of family members coming round. You know, within our Somali culture, that's one thing that I love about my culture, is that we're always so, you know, within each other. You know, whether it's your cousins, your aunties, your uncle, your grandma, your granddad, everybody's just so connected. And that's one thing, you know, I definitely love about my So fact number 10 about me is that I have a skin condition called acne that I'm sure, you know, a lot of other people out there suffer from as well. For me, growing up, it was really especially hard for me because, you know, I'd see other people with clear skin and I'd wonder, what's wrong with me? Why don't I have clear skin? Why do my friends all have clear skin? Why do my cousins, my sisters, my relatives, they all got clear skin? What's wrong with me? And I'd ask all these, you know, questions about me. And then I learned to love myself and I learned to love my body for the way that it is. And that's what I encourage you to do as well. You know, maybe your skin condition might not be great and maybe, you know, you've got an imperfection about yourself, but that doesn't make you imperfect. You know, your imperfections are what makes you perfect. And you shouldn't let it get you down, and you shouldn't, you know, you should try to overcome it. And I don't think there's anything wrong with going out there and seeking help, whether that's using cosmetics, whether that's using laser, anything that makes you happy. I think you should definitely go after that. Obviously within reason, I think, you know, for me, myself, I know personally myself, you know, I do use makeup and other things to cover myself because that's an insecurity that I'm still struggling with, and I'm still working on dealing with it. And sometimes it's difficult because, you know, you want people to accept you for the way that you are and the way that society is right now. Like, we all have to look perfect. You know, eyebrows need to be on fleek, your skin needs to be perfect, you need to have the perfect body shape, the number 8. You know, all of these expectations that they place on us as women, but no expectations is placed on our intellect. No, you know, expectations is placed on being educated and changing the world and doing positive things in this world and making a real difference in the world. You know, more importance needs to be placed on that. You know, that's what I'm advocating for. I want girls to be, as much as I encourage young girls to love themselves, to love their bodies, and whether that's through makeup, you know, doing all these other, you know, cosmetic and materialistic things, that's absolutely great and there's nothing wrong with that. But I think we also need to place value on our intellect. We need to place value on, you know, education and other aspects of ourselves that, you know, will make a difference in other people's lives. And for me, I've learned that my acne doesn't define me, and your skin condition, it shouldn't define you either. You know, you're better than your skin condition. And whatever it is, whatever insecurity is, whether it's to do with your skin, your weight, it could be about anything. Don't let that define you. You know, that doesn't define who you are and what you bring to the world. You know, you're incredibly important, and you know, you have so much great things to offer. And I hope you don't let your image and your body let that affect you in a way that, you know, it outshines who you really are. Because real beauty comes from within, and you know, you have real beauty within yourself. And don't let society make you believe that you're not beautiful just because you're not society's version of beautiful. You're beautiful because that's how you have been developed, that's how you've been created uniquely. You know, you're beautiful just the way you are. So that's 10 facts about me. If you got any questions, or if you want to leave any comments, or if you want to subscribe, be sure to do that. If you guys want any videos that you guys want me to talk about, whether it's self-esteem, confidence, dealing with anxiety, anything like that, you know, be sure to leave your comments, and be sure to email me and let me know what you think. Thank you for watching. Bye guys.